Now, the Prime Minister is in Austria, and we're expecting an India-Austria joint statement. This is, again, the beginning of a new chapter when it comes to India-Austria ties.
In the world, and therefore, India's role, especially for Austria, is more than important when it comes to the peace process and future peace summits. As a reliable partner, Austria will be available as a site for dialogue, making use of its unique position as a neutral country, a member of the European Union, but not a member of NATO. As such, Austria is willing to act as a bridge builder and to contribute towards the achievement of a peaceful solution. Let me move on to economic relations. Currently, the world economy finds itself in a challenging situation. Against this background, it is particularly important for Austria, a strongly export-oriented country, to find new forms of economic cooperation. Today already, there are excellent economic and trade relations with India, marked by mutual trust and confidence. 2.7 billion euro is the current trade volume. More than 150 Austrian businesses are operating in India, and we expect the number to increase, and there will also be Indian investments in Austria. There is high demand for economic cooperation, particularly when it comes to renewable energy, about environment and urban technology, urban development and infrastructure development. It's impressive to look at India's success when it comes to infrastructure, digitalization in society and developing infrastructure at an enormous pace. Today's business forum, which is taking place right now at the Vienna Hofburg, about 40 businesses from India and Austria are coming together to engage in new cooperation and in identifying new economic opportunities. For me, as Austrian Federal Chancellor, cooperation in the field of science is important. Intensified cooperation between universities in Austria and in India. There is no better means of bringing different cultures and civilizations together than to ensure that young people can meet, have encounters in many ways. If you're working together on projects, learning on projects, experiencing technological progress and further developing it, this is particularly important. India has fascinating projects, and Austria has built an impressive level of know-how. So in the field of science and research, we want to intensify our cooperation. 41 years ago, that was the last time a prime minister of India visited Austria. I'm particularly happy that we are able to further build and develop cooperation with the world's biggest democracy in the interest of a good future for future generations. Thank you very much.
Your Excellency, Chancellor Karl Nehmer, dono deshon ke delegates, media ke saathiyon, namaskar. Sabse pehle, main garm joshi bhare swagat aur aatithya satkar ke liye Chancellor Nehmer ka aabhar prakat karta hoon. Mujhe khushi hai कि मेरे तीसरे कार्यकाल की शुरुआत और शुरुआत में ही ऑस्ट्रिया आने का अवसर मिला. मेरी यह यात्रा ऐतिहासिक भी है और विशेष भी है. 41 साल के बाद किसी भारतीय प्रधानमंत्री ने ऑस्ट्रिया का दौरा किया है। ये भी सुखद संयोग है कि ये यात्रा उस समय हो रही है जब हमारे आपसी संबंधों के 75 साल पूरे हुए हैं। फ्रेंड्स, लोकतंत्र और रूल ऑफ लॉ जैसे मूल्यों में साझा विश्वास हमारे संबंधों की मजबूत नींव है। आपसी विश्वास और शेयर्ड इंटरेस्ट से हमारे रिश्तों को बल मिलता है। आज मेरे और चांसलर नेहमर के बीच बहुत सार्थक बातचीत हुई। हमने आपसी सहयोग को और मजबूत करने के लिए नई संभावनाओं की पहचान की है। हमने निर्णय लिया है कि संबंधों को स्ट्रैटेजिक दिशा प्रदान की जाएगी। आने वाले दशक के लिए सहयोग का खाका तैयार किया गया है। यह केवल आर्थिक सहयोग और निवेश तक सीमित नहीं है। इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर विकास, इनोवेशन, रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी, हाइड्रोजन, वाटर एंड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट, आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, क्वांटम जैसे क्षेत्रों में एक दूसरे के सामर्थ्य को जोड़ने का काम किया जाएगा। दोनों देशों की युवा शक्ति और आइडियाज को कनेक्ट करने के लिए स्टार्टअप ब्रिज को गति दी जाएगी।